Hello everyone. In other coding languages, we have things like for loops and while loops. This is a form of processing, a processing loop. So how does COBOL deal with processing loops? And that's what I'll be discussing in this video. If you've seen the last video I made, you'll recognize this program here. What it does is accepts a number that you enter and then counts up to that number. It's just a simple program. And it does it by using perform. And I went over perform and how you can get perform to repeat several times by using the keyword times or reserve word times and the variable counter. So that could be an integer, but it's got a counter. It's a variable that holds an integer. So it's the same kind of thing. It's just, it means that you can change it. It gets this piece of code to run. And we've got this part here and this if condition. Now, there's another way of doing this. And if I go to this program, this is a new program. Now we're going to look at the differences here. And the first difference that we can see here is this display counting. Whereas on this one, it's display counting. And then you've got the how many times you want it to count. On this one, it doesn't. And we've got these new reserve words. And we've got a bunch of them. We've got varying, until, form, and by. Now what's happening here is it's taking a number, a variable, and it's initializing it. So it's saying from one, it wants to count up. So it's saying from one, count up by one, until some condition is met. This is like a while loop. Whereas this one is like a for loop, because in the for loop, you know how many times you want to run it. Even if it's a variable, you still know that variable is going to be a certain amount. Here, it's more like a while loop because there's a condition that needs to be met before it finishes. So it's not running a set number of times. It's reaching a condition. Usually that condition would be like something that is true or false. And it is actually here, because if count number is greater than counter, then it's true. And if count number is less than or equal to counter, that it's false. So let's have a look and see this program running. So it asks us to enter a number, 9. Now it counts to 9. It counts to 9 just the same way as the last program does. However, down in this paragraph, there's something different here. If we go back to the other one, what we've got here is display counting has this add to 1 to counter. Well, that's being done up here. And down here, we've got if counter is less than counter plus 1, that condition there is no longer needed, because we've got these two are dealing with those conditions. What we've covered in this video so far, the processing loop. The processing loop is a paragraph or more paragraphs running in a loop. So they keep repeating until a certain condition is met. And we have the processing control here, we have the processing control, and then we have the stuff that is going to be executed, the stuff that's going to run again and again. And we call this the process control loop. Here, this is setting the conditions. It's the processing control. It's controlling how many times this paragraph is displayed, or run, rather, I should say. The summary of this section covers really the last few videos that I've done. And we've done perform, go to, and processing loops, and we've been over how they're connected together. Perform. This one changes the flow of the program by instructing the nominated paragraph to be executed. And as we saw in the video that I did on perform, it will jump to that paragraph, basically. It will execute that paragraph line by line. And then when it gets to the end of that paragraph, it will bounce back to the sentence in the perform statement. So it goes back to the perform. So if you have perform paragraph A, it then jumps to paragraph A, performs every line in there, and then it bounces back to the end of perform paragraph A, and then continues from there. For this reason, a lot of the perform statements will be after stop run, otherwise they're going to run twice. And also, it's good to remember that you can put perform inside of a perform, so you can have nested performs. Go to is a bit of a bad boy of the group, and you wouldn't use it in your coding, but we need to know about it because it will be in other people's coding. You're going to find it in code if you're working with COBOL, and you need to know what it does, why it's been used, and also why you don't use it. It just causes too many problems. So just as long as you remember not to use it yourself. But when you do come across it, just remember that GoTo is very similar to perform in that it directs the flow of the program to a nominated paragraph, but doesn't bounce back, unlike perform. If you remember, perform bounces back to the end of the sentence. Using perform a certain amount of times, like it was a for loop, and this is very much like a for loop where you designate how many times you want something to go through the loop. So you could say perform a paragraph 10 times or 5 times, perform it 5 times or 6 times. But obviously it's got to be a positive integer. You can use a variable, as long as that variable contains a positive integer, you'll be fine. So it acts very much like a for loop, and you can have a specified number of times. Perform varying from, by, and until using these. That's very much the same as the last one, except for this is more like a while loop. And while a certain condition is there or is not being met, while a certain condition is not being met, then it keeps running. That's what the until is about. You don't really need to put in the variant from and by, but you would do if you want something to increment by something. So the varying, then comes the variable. Then you have from, which is the starting point, and by is how much it increments by until a certain condition is met. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a like and come and check out my channel, see what else I've got to offer.